Park, Australia, for today's race, and I think it's shaping up to be a classic. What a great start to the season for Nico Rosberg. He's on pole for today's race. He'll be delighted with how qualifying went yesterday, but knows there's a lot of hard work to come before he can secure that race win.
Well, Nico will be focused on the task at hand. He's on pole position, he's proven his speed, and if he can just stay out in front, he should be able to create a gap. So I think he's got a good chance of victory today, as long as he has no car issues along the way.
Daniel Kvyat looks to have the upper hand on Daniel Ricciardo this weekend. He really is dialed into this track.
Beware the Russian Crofty. He's on fire so far this weekend, and looks to be able to get more out of that Red Bull over this circuit than Ricciardo can. Can he keep that going for the duration of the race, though?
What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Let's play F1 2015 Part 1. Here we are on the grid for the Australian Grand Prix, and as you can see, there is quite a big difference between F1 2014 and F1 2015 at the start of a race. We now have two commentators from, I believe, the Sky Sports Formula 1 broadcast team. I believe is who those two guys are. And the way that you can see the qualifying order is you have to sit through that. I can't sit here and bring it up now. The only thing I can really show you is just the race strategy. From here, I can't look at my practice times, like in-depth qualifying times. I can't look at any of that. All I can do is just sit through that to show you the qualifying order, which I will do. I am Nico Rosberg this year instead of one of the Red Bulls, because the Red Bulls, while their car, the car handling is so much better than the Mercedes, just the outright pace of the Mercedes, it makes it better to switch to the Mercedes than stay with the Red Bull. This year I hate doing it, because I've stayed with Red Bull, you know, since F1 2010, but just the speed is just so much better here with the Mercedes, and it will cut down on the race time. You know, these races are already going to be long. They have been long the last race, the videos that I've done for F1 2013 and 14, the races have been long enough, so that's why I wanted to go ahead and switch to the Mercedes to kind of speed that up a little bit. But I'm going to go ahead and show off the race strategy, so you can see here. I'm starting on the prime tires, two fast lap old prime tires, and that does make a big difference. The fast laps compared in 2014, it did make a difference, but it wasn't that big. In 2015, there is a very big difference how many laps you run on fast tires, or how many fast laps you put on a set of tires. So these are going to wear a lot quicker. They say these tires will last 25 laps. I would assume 22 to 23 laps now, so I'm gonna have to come in and pit a little bit sooner. Obviously, I'm not gonna follow their strategy. I'm gonna do my own strategy that I want to, and I can even change that strategy if I want to. I'm not gonna mess with this really all that much. I could have swore I could change it, but maybe I can't. Maybe just because the starting tire, I can't change the tires anyway. So I don't know what this screen is for, but so that's the strategy. I'm gonna try to stick with all. Pit about lap 25 or 22 to 25, somewhere in there. If I can make it to 25, I will. But and the way, there's a couple other changes that I want to mention. I will be able to listen to my crew chief, and I'll be able to ask him certain questions, weather, race, who's behind me, who's ahead of me, you know, different things like that. When I'm going to pit, tire wear, just different things like that. I'll be able to ask them or ask him these questions. Which I will be doing very often throughout the race. And the way that they show fuel is changed. It shows it how much kilos you have in the car now, and a minus number, whatever that is, means you are low on, you know, you're under fueled. I think it should say like optimum range or something like that if you're in the best range you could be for the race, and then any plus numbers means you have an excess amount of fuel. For whatever reason, almost every car every team in this game makes fuel, even if you run on fast laps for a little while. Very easily the Red Bull makes better than the Mercedes, and and the Ferrari. The Ferrari does a little bit better than the Mercedes, but those are the only teams I've really paid attention to that with. The Red Bull, because you can sit there and run fast lap after fast lap and just keep making fuel, I guess, just because of how slow the car goes. But so you'll notice that. I'll try to show that off as often, whenever I think about it, just throughout the race. But yeah, that's pretty much everything that I wanted to mention, pre-race stuff. My other pre-races won't be this long. There's just a lot of new changes into this game that I wanted to add that are kind of necessary to add and to talk about. But anyway, so I'm going to go ahead and stop the pre-race stuff. See you on the track.
Should have some space going into the first corner, so try to keep it tidy. Until your pit window is open. Okay. there's enough fuel in the tank to get us through the whole race. Remember that we'll get lighter and faster as we get through it. If a storm front does appear, then we'll let you know. Okay, tyres still looking good, Nick. Let's keep them that way for as long as we can. Try to warm up the brakes. Brake hard in the next few corners. You are in first position, front of the pack. That's Lewis behind. The gap is 8 seconds. Your pit window opens in 9 laps time. Thank you. behind you. The gap is 12 seconds. Your pit window will open in 7 laps time. About a lap's worth of spare fuel in the car. You won't be able to run in mix 3 for long with that much, but do burn it if you need to. Position, front of the pack. That's Lewis behind. The gap is 15 seconds plus. 6 laps until your pit window is open. Okay, fuel update. We've just dipped under 80 kilos of fuel. 80 kilos of fuel remaining. The brakes are running too cold. Going off the sim data, we expect you're going to start feeling the effect of tire wear around about now. Let us know if it gets too bad. Your brakes are in the optimum temperature zone. Tires are getting a bit worn at this point. You may notice a gradual loss in grip. They should still have a bit left though. Good job. That was the fastest lap of the race so far. Next lap. We're going to fit options on your next stop. 48 laps to go. Tires. We're seeing some significant signs of wear now. You may start struggling on them before too long. You're leading the pack, P1. Lewis is behind you. Around 20 plus seconds separate you. Your pit window is open. Box. Closes this lap. to pit in this lap. 75% of our starting fuel, so that's three quarters left. The car should be feeling a bit lighter now. The fastest lap of the race. Keep this up. You are in first position, front of the pack. That's Lewis behind. The gap is around half a minute. Your pit window will open in 40 laps time. 40 laps to go now. Forward. Okay, the incident has been cleared. Let's get back up to racing speed. for you. Everything's looking nice and tidy on our end. Let us know if you start to feel any issues. Separates you. Should remain dry. We will keep you informed of any changes to the weather. Low chance of rain now. If the situation changes, we'll let you know. Position, front of the pack. That's Lewis behind. Around 40 plus separates the two of you. Pit window will open in 10 laps time. Pit window opens in 10 laps. 36 laps to go. We now have 60 kilograms of fuel remaining. That was the fastest lap of the race. Keep this up. Softer braking, your brakes are overheating. If you keep this up, it could become a problem. Until your pit window is open. 32 laps to go. Trouble for the time being, but the grip is going to start falling away. Thank you. okay. I'm sure you can feel it already, but we're starting to notice some tire wear now. They should be good for a while longer, though. Here's a heads up on the current fuel. We have 50 kilograms remaining. 50 kilos. Careful on the tires. Our data is showing some wear. Most likely you'll be able to feel it. racing speed. This lap. In terms of fuel, our data suggests we have around half our initial load remaining, 50% fuel. Position, front of the pack. That's Lewis behind. A full lap separates you. Your pit window is open. Pit window is open. 24 laps to go. On your next stop. You're probably feeling quite a bit of tyre wear about now. Stay out as long as you're quick, but there's probably not much left in them. Box, box, box. Changing your brake balance forward might reduce your rear lockups. Green flag. Green flag. We're racing again. To pit in this lap. Okay, you only have to stop once now. One stop left. Be aware, there's an incident in the next part of the track. No overtaking through the yellow flags. Track is clear. Green flag. Thank you. I'm not seeing any issues with tyre wear right now. You should have good grip for a while yet. Fastest lap for the race. To 40% fuel, 40%. Separated by an entire lap. Your pit window opens in 9 laps time. 18 laps to go. suits aren't looking too worn at this point. We should have plenty of life left in them. Let's make sure we keep managing them properly. Speed. Starting to notice some wear. We should be okay for a bit longer though. You are in first position, front of the pack. That's Lewis behind. to pit this lap. Some significant drop-off in grip around now. The data suggests the tyres are getting quite worn. They may not last much longer. Don't forget, pit in this lap. Of fuel. That's 25 remaining. Okay, we're ready for you. Box this lap. Strategy complete. See these tires through to the end now. Position, front of the pack. That's Lewis behind. Look after these tyres now. We want to finish the race on this compound. 9 laps to go. drive tank. That's 25% fuel remaining. The fastest lap of the race so far. Situation at the moment. We have 20 kilos remaining. That's 20 kilos. looks like we've just hit the 15 kilo mark in terms of fuel. 15 kilos of fuel remain. Are getting too hot. Try and be less aggressive through the corners.
That's a win for Nico Rosberg at the Australian Grand Prix here in Melbourne. What a result for this German driver.
What a fantastic result for Nico. He'll be so happy to start the season on such a positive note.
That's it for today's Grand Prix, and from Ant and I, it's goodbye and see you again next time.